Yes. That's how you start the first episode. Give us a backstory. Give us the reason why the world is in despair in the current time. Well, not our current time, but their current time. Give us a reason why we should hate these characters, love these characters, root for these characters to have a good ending, or maybe cry if they have a sad one. Also, set up the story, not just the main one, but also side stories that may have a connection with the main one, or if not, but keep it interesting, and that's what they did. And it's only the first episode. So first, let's get to the introduction, basically the backstory of the first episode. I am not trying to memorize it, so... Anyway, long ago, humans lived in harmony with nature and beings that were not visible to the human eye. There were three deities called Samshin. The eldest one presided over birth, the second one presided over death, and the third one was the balance between both birth and death. One day, the deity of death craved more blood, so what it did was ate the deity that was the balance of birth and death. And then the world fell into despair and demons basically fed off the greed of humans. One day, a woman painted something, sealed the deity of death, but then the woman disappeared. Then we get to King Yongjong. He ruled the world with a demon inside of him, but was afraid that he might pass the demon to his son Songjo, which we do see later on in this episode. So what he decided was to perform a ritual to get the demon out of him and seal him in the painting, just like the woman did in the introduction. Then next we see a woman praying for the ritual to have no problems. At the same time, she goes into labor, and then we see wolves basically creeping up in front of her. She is praying for the ritual to be done, but then she prays for a deity to protect her child. God Samshin does come and protect the child and takes the child away, and then the mom looks like she fainted, but I think she passed. Then as for the king, he is strapped onto a throne. Uno, who is the father of Chongi, which is the baby that we saw earlier, he painted the portrait of a king so they can seal the demon inside the king into the portrait. First, there was a little trouble, but then God Samshin came in and helped out. Before the deity of death went inside the painting, he said to Uno, remember, Uno is the one that painted the portrait of the king so they can seal the deity of death inside it. Before he went inside though, he said, I'm going to curse your child so your child can no longer paint. And then he goes inside. Then God Samshin, the elder, over birth, she said, I can't take the curse away from you, but I can match you with someone who can protect you from the curse. At the same time, we see Haram being born. Now, 9 years later, we see that the ritual was a success, but because of the curse, the Dan Dynasty was in despair. Famine and drought. No water. People are dying. We're basically seeing people in that village, in that moment of the episode, dying. But then we see a group of people with a young Haram finding water. And then we find out from Misu that Haram has the energy of water. And then next we do see a younger Chongi, and she's blind. Later on we do see the interaction with the kids, which is pretty cute. But then we do see God Samshin disguising herself as a human, but we know who she is, giving Haram a butterfly bracelet. I think it's a bracelet, but I know there was a butterfly on it. And then that was the end of that scene, but that butterfly does come into play. But then, the next scene, we see both their dads talking. So according to Haram's dad, Haram has been chosen to participate in the rain-making ritual. Because he was born with the energy of water, King Songjo got the news from Misu, but he announced that we're still going to hold the ritual, but without human sacrifice. Sticking with King Songjo, he has three sons. The eldest one is taking the throne. The other two, they did a little which caused the problem. The first thing they did was just walk around. Then they enter a room, which I think it was restricted. One of them, his name is Iu, he basically hears voices coming from the room, which says, he is to be king, come to me. He opens the door, and it's a portrait of his grandfather, the painting that Uno painted at the beginning of this episode. And what he did was he grabbed a lit candle and set the portrait on fire, which released the deity over death. And then Once that demon was out, he basically caused havoc during the rain-making ritual. He went after Hatam because he had the energy of water. And then after that, Chungi fell into the water. Then Hatam fell into the water. When Hatam was in the water, God Samshin, disguising herself as a butterfly, said that you've sacrificed yourself for tens of thousands of people. Now I'm going to take the source of your powers, your eyes, took it away from him and gave it to Chungi. If you're reading the description of this drama, it says that Hatam was blind, not Chungi. But before, towards the ending of this episode, it was actually the other way around. And that was the end of the episode. So my impression on the first episode, you can already tell by my intro of my review video, I'm clapping and whatnot. Like, it was good. It was really, really good. I like it. First off, the backstory. I love a good backstory. Give me information on why is the world is in despair. Don't just start the episode and make me think, oh, that's how later on in the episode. No, give it to me now and then start your storytelling. The way they did it was perfect in my opinion. Also, the CGI, it's not perfect. I'm pretty sure this drama doesn't have a big budget like Marvel. But the CGI in this drama so far did what it was supposed to do. Entertained us. If you weren't entertained, I don't know what to say, but I was. Now for the characters. Misu, she seems like the human villain in this drama because she does have that type of vibe where she kind of stirs the pot for some problems to occur later on in this drama. Now speaking of bad people, I think Yu could be one of the villains in this drama because, well, first, he wants the throne. He lit the portrait on fire. He was the one that set the deity over death free. So yeah, he wants the throne. He's obviously going to do something evil. If you think about it, they're giving us two different stories. One is with Hatam and Chungi, and the second one is with Yu wanting the throne. So far, they're giving us two different stories, but most likely that they're going to link all of the stories together. Now for Chungi and Hatam, their story can go many ways, to be honest. And here's the thing, I don't want to predict now because it's only the first episode. I mean, Chungi does have his eyes, not in a father-daughter eyes kind of way, but literally she has his eyes. So maybe her character might pass so he can use his power or something. I don't know, but yeah, I don't want to predict now. And yeah, that's pretty much the gist of the episode and my review. If there's anything I might have missed, please leave it in the comments below. There were a lot of stuff that happened in this episode. I'm pretty sure I missed maybe one or two things, but again, leave it in the comments below. Other than that, if you like this video, leave a like, comment down below, and subscribe. See ya.